The seventh mistake people do on keto, which prevents weight loss, is that they chase ketone numbers. People automatically assume that the higher the ketone numbers equates to greater weight loss. And what ends up happening is because they're chasing the higher ketone numbers, they eat more fats, which is unnecessary. Eating more fats stops your body's ability to burn its own fat, because all it's going to be doing is digesting, metabolizing the dietary fat, and not giving a chance to burn its own fats. In addition, people panic when they find their ketone numbers, for example, reduced from 0.8 and 0.7, and they will usually get an email first thing in the morning, panicking and saying, why my ketone levels have dropped? Just remember using a machine to test your ketone levels. These machines are not 100% accurate. So every time you test, you may get a different result. It's not worth panicking over, because when you panic, you stress. And when you stress, you release cortisol. Cortisol is a hormone that stores fat. In addition to that, cortisol increases your blood sugar levels. And again, we don't want to have higher blood sugar levels while we're consuming a whole amount of fat. Higher sugar levels in the body reduces your body's ability to burn fat, hence reducing the amount of fat you'll burn and preventing weight loss. There is no correlation between ketone numbers and how much fat you're actually burning, so don't make that connection. All you need to be is on a low number of ketones, just enough for your body to be burning fat, and that's all you need. Just remember, when you're trying to get in ketosis, that's when you need a lot of fat. But once you're fat adapted and you're ready to lose a whole lot of fat, that's when you have to pull the fat back and not worry so much about your ketone levels, especially that using a machine, and especially by you stressing is going to increase cortisol, and that way you're going to be putting on weight. Ketone numbers will always fluctuate. There are many reasons why your blood sugar levels rise, which affects your ketone readings. Now, if you've done the right thing, you're having the right amount of carbohydrates, and you're not exceeding your protein intake, and you're having the right amount of fats, then there's nothing to worry about. There are things you can control, which your diet, and there are things you can't control. For instance, if you get upset or beep at somebody at the traffic light and get upset and angry, that raises your blood sugar levels, and that will affect your ketone reading. Not having enough sleep is another one, or sleeping too much sometimes, or sleeping too little, that will also affect your blood ketone levels. Getting sick is another one. When you get sick, your blood sugar levels rise and your ketones drop. For women, for instance, when you have your monthly cycle, you're automatically out of ketosis, but that's natural. That's nothing you can do about it. And as soon as that's over, your body goes back in ketosis. There's a big difference between a natural way of coming out of ketosis, for example, like getting sick, and deliberately having carbohydrates. They're two different things. So if you're sick or you have your monthly cycle, don't stress about your ketone levels. They will go up naturally. Do not have extra fat, thinking by jacking up your fat, you can fix this problem. If it's your body's natural way of raising its blood sugar level for survival, whether it's sick or having its monthly cycle, do not have extra fat. That's just going to cause more weight gain. On my next video, I'll be showing you another mistake people commonly do in the keto diet that prevents weight loss. I'll see you next time.